Good morning, guys. Welcome to my channel. I am playing Horizon Forbidden West. It is a sequel to Horizon Zero Dawn that came out all the way back in the PS4 era. I originally never played the first game on the PS4. I played it when it came out on PC, and then I went back to go play it, the PS4 version, and it's a really fun game. I enjoyed it a lot, and I can't wait to start playing this game. It just came out, so yeah, there's nothing else to say, but let's do it.
Through a lifetime spent in the pursuit of knowledge, one question consumed me. How did our world come to be? The old ones perished 1,000 years ago, triggering the extinction of all life. She showed me how it was reborn. A little outcast girl, ignorant of her own importance. Through her, I learned that life was only saved through a technological miracle. Zero Dawn. A terraforming system composed of 9 subordinate functions, each playing its part to reshape Earth from a barren rock to a lush landscape. Tended and protected by the machines. And with her, I learned the deepest secret of them all. The secret of her birth. That she is a clone of Elizabeth Subek, Zero Dawn's creator. Born to prevent a new extinction. Driven by Hades, a malevolent AI. Given sentience by a mysterious signal of unknown origin. And with a little help from me. She prevailed in a great battle at the city of Meridian. Becoming a champion for all humankind. But as useful as she has been, now, I must leave her behind. For as she strives to put right what Hades sundered, I have made a new discovery. One that heralds both destruction and opportunity.
What are you doing, Silence? Better not be bad. Horizon 2 Forbidden West. Let's take a quick look at the settings real quick. Graphics mode, favorite resolution. Let's go for performance, because I don't really have like the kind of monitor that would actually, you know, favor resolution, since it's only 1080p, I think. So let's go for performance, because that's like a more notable difference. Climbing annotations always on. Underwater camera shake. That's interesting. Right, so you can actually swim underwater and stuff in this game. Because I remember the first one, I just played that recently a couple weeks ago, and in the first game, you can't go underneath. You can only swim above the surface of the water. So I can't wait to see what kind of stuff you can do in this game. Also, I'm guessing that you can probably get some gear or unlockables that will help you breathe underwater. So you can like look for treasure and stuff like that. That's what I'm really hoping. Copyright and trademark, recap movie. I think that's what I just watched, right? The recap? New game. Okay, so I'm an experienced player for Horizon, but I'm not that experienced. I'm not experienced enough to go hard or very hard. Let's just go normal. That's a safe route, because if it gets hard, then I'm not going to change it. Even if it's not normal, so let's just keep it that way. Assistance. Oh, what's this? Explorer. Minimal HUD information. Look at the world to find your way. Guided. Markers and icons on screen to assist you on your journey. Minimal HUD information. Look at the world. Look at the world. It's kind of, is that like Ghost of Tsushima, where the wind takes you where you have to go? I want to have a feeling that's what it is. So, Explorer seems like a more immersive, because minimal HUD information, but Guided just means probably like default, like the way it was in the first game. Let's go with Guided, just in case.
Of a terraforming system that's spiraling out of control. And only I can fix it. Only I have your genetic code. It won't be long before we hit the point of no return. And then, extinction. I've been searching for months for what I need. A backup of Gaia, the AI you designed to control the system. Same dream. I'm walking under a brilliant night sky, through a field of flowers. And when I arrive at the center, I see you, Elizabeth. Waiting for me. Even though you've been dead for 1,000 years. You're the closest person I've ever had to a mother. And for a moment, I feel whole. This world is your legacy, Elizabeth. I won't let it slip away. The valley below is my only remaining lead. My last hope to find the backup. I'll do whatever it takes to get it. I promise.
If it isn't Aloy, the savior of Meridian, anointed of the Nora.
You know I hate being called that stuff.
Well, consider it a punishment for running out on us the very same night we beat Hades.
I grew up an outcast. Remember, I'm not much for parties.
Yeah. But that one was in your honor. Just saying.
So, what are we doing?
Must be urgent since you left so fast. Delving into ancient ruins? Or maybe it has something to do with the Blight.
Both, actually, but, I should...
Oh, no. I've been tracking you a long way. It's okay. After everything you've done to help Lenora and my family, I swore an oath to help you, no matter what. But you're stuck with me now. Like bark on wood.
Okay, but if you're going to come with me, you'll need to be able to see what I see.
A focus. Never thought I'd get your second sight.
I'll give you another one later and show you how to back up your data.
Data?
Information on the device. We've got a lot to cover. I'll have to explain everything as we go.
You see like this all the time?
Since I was a little girl. Come on. Shall we? Couple of scrapes on the way here. We should find some medicinal plants. Stock up. So it's time for your first lesson with the focus.
Sounds good. Let's get started.
All right, here we are. The game.
These plants don't look like the ones in the sacred lands.
The focus helps you see the ones we need.
Yeah, it feels kind of weird. This time, I'm the teacher. You can store a limited amount of medicinal berries in your medicine pouch. Tap the top once to heal using medicinal berries for your medicine pouch. So the medicinal berries. That's different, because in the first one, it was just plants. I'm going to keep comparing to the first game, because they're pretty much alike. Except different story, different visuals. Yeah, the visuals, they look amazing. Just look at this. That looks really great. I love this a lot. Oh my god, I'm never getting over it. I'm never getting over it. Let's heal.
Bitter?
No, at least they make you feel better. Alright, we should keep going.
Might want to grab more of these plants along the way.
Yeah, good idea.
Now I'm wondering how many skills in the first game you naturally have in this game. Because I noticed that she already rides on the machines, which is a skill in the first game. And I wonder if there's other stuff she can do that's from there that you don't have to unlock again. What's this? There's a sign here. There's like a little icon. What does that mean? Let's look over here. Anything secret? How do you go under the water? Or is it not shallow enough? Yeah, I don't think so. It's like a little pond. I need to find like a big ocean or lake to really explore the underwater ocean or underwater lake.
Those ruins. That's where we need to go.
I see a few ways down. What are we after exactly?
The backup? Well, it's an AI. It's hard to explain. Think of it like a set of instructions that can fix the world.
Sounds complicated. Noticed you're traveling light these days.
Yeah, I ran into some trouble on the way here. Lost a lot of my gear.
The little message in the side of the screen says to press circle once I'm in the apex of my jump to dive into the water. That did not work. That's where I pressed it, but nothing happened. But look at this. I'm underwater. Take all. Okay, seems like my basic breathing is long enough, honestly. Now, how to go up? X.
Find anything good down there?
A few supplies.
Now, how to go back down? Square. That looks dangerous. I don't want to go that way. Let's go this way. Follow me. We are going this way.
There's more of the red growths here, too. Salvaging machine carcasses as usual. And there they go.
Looks like they left a carcass behind.
They left a carcass? Where is it? Oh, damn.
A lot of arrows in that machine. Better take a closer look. Someone took down this machine recently.
Who else would come?
I don't know. We better craft some arrows of our own. There might be trouble up ahead.
There's some ridgewood by the stream.
All right, you grab some sticks to make arrows. Very basic.
All right, now to craft some arrows.
Right, of course, I know how to do it. Hold L1 to open the weapon wheel. All right, select the arrow using the right stick and hold X to quick craft hunter arrows. Go up and press X.
Done.
Me too. Arrows ready. There's a ladder, but can't reach it from here.
Nothing a well-placed arrow can't knock free. Just have to target the lock.
Looks like I can reach it fine, but okay, I'll shoot it.
After you.
You know, for a sec there, I totally forgot I was playing on the PS5 because the triggers were doing the adaptive thing. The haptic feedback trigger was doing that thing with the bow and arrow, and I totally forgot that was the thing. Oh yeah, I can feel it.
By the gods. What was this place?
I don't know. The transmission, the message I found. Didn't say. Only that a backup might be here. We need to find a way in. So, what happened after I left Meridian?
Well, there was a fuss when people realized you were gone. But then some of us figured you only would have left if it were for something important.
You were right about that.
Seen one of those before.
Me neither. Those dead machines have it on alert.
How do you want to handle it?
The focus can help us. We can scan the machine before we make our move.
Okay.
Give it a second. Okay. See how parts of it are glowing? Those are its weak spots.
Got it.
Yo, I can scroll? That's new.
It's I. It's a weak spot.
Right.
I can press the middle button to view in notepad. Not the middle button, the touchpad. Okay, so I distinguish that its eye is the only weak spot, so that's where I'm gonna aim.
Okay, concentrate.
Slow time while aiming to increase your accuracy. This is called concentration. Okay, so you do have some of your skills from the first game. Just gonna wait for it to look back at me. Chill, don't move. I got this. There we go, got it. One shot in the eyeball. Take everything.
Another one's coming.
I see that. That should have been a one shot.
How does the focus know all that?
It reads data on the machine.
Like a hunter studying its prey?
Yeah. So after the fuss over me leaving, what did everyone else do?
Well, as soon as the celebration was over, my mother led the rest of the Nora home. Sun King put his people to work rebuilding the city. And I set out to find you. You said you've had a focus since you were a child, right?
Yeah, found my first one when I fell into a ruin. Got the others from an old cache not long ago. It's good to have extras.
Yeah, you know, I was wondering how there's other focuses and where she found them.
Going into a ruin of the old ones. Goddess protect us.
Welcome to the Far Zenith.
We'll be okay, Vaughn. Far Zenith? I know they made some tech trades with Zero Dawn, but why would they have a backup of Gaia?
Please register with reception for the tour.
I guess they want us to check in with them.
Please hold for identiscan. Access denied. Please wait here for personnel to assist you. Dr. Sobek.
Okay. I guess they weren't on great terms with Elizabeth. Well, let's find a way in.
Ancient chimes. Iron ingot.
Please hold.
Oh, take everything.
Scan. Access denied. Credentials not recognized.
I guess it doesn't like me either.
I should be able to pry this open.
Prying doors. New mechanic.
There's climbing gear. Guess someone dropped in from above. Whoever left this here might have also shot those machines we found earlier.
So where are they now?
Couldn't tell you.
Ugh. What's that stench?
Entire camp. Wiped out. They must have come here to delve for scrap.
Acid. That explains the smell. And it looks like something big came in from above.
Crashed right through the camp. Then through the wall. I should take a look at the rubble in that gap.
Ooh, look, it's a dummy! I did it! You killed him! Okay, so what was my objective? Examine the rubble and the collapsed wall. Take everything.
Whatever came through here brought this down as it went out. If I can dislodge some of the debris, we might be able to squeeze through. Maybe I can find something to help in the camp.
Aloy, over here. I think I got something. It's some kind of Osirum prototype, I think. This hook looks like it can latch onto things.
And this gear pulls it back.
It looks broken, but maybe we can repair it. Hook it to the debris.
And pull it out. That could work. The focus can help us search the camp and identify anything we can use to fix the tool. My focus picked up a couple of things to check out.
Poor guy. Acid burned right through his armor.
Part of a machine. Could help fix the gears.
Alright, something over here.
Machine cable. Stronger than rope. Alright, I think I have what I need to repair the tool. Or maybe even make something better.
You could use this workbench.
How could be like the only place in the camp that wasn't destroyed is the workbench? This looks nice. Pole caster, special gear, legendary. An improved version of a Delver's prototype tool that can latch onto and pull objects. Also enables grappling to specific points.
There. Pole caster. Now to test it on the debris.
The polecaster is a versatile tool that allows you to manipulate objects in the environment that have a graded pattern. A graded pattern. To wield the polecaster, hold L2 and tap triangle. Okay, I see now.
That worked better than I thought.
What's this thing?
What's
this? Huh. What's this thing for?
Guess we'll never find out.
Didn't turn up much. I better scan.
Whoa.
Good morning. I'm Oswald Dahlgard, and it is my pleasure to introduce you to Far Zenith. Forget what you think you know about us. Our truth is simple. We still reach for the stars, even if you have to cross 8.6 light years of space to get there. Please, proceed into the auditorium, where we'll unveil our plans.
Wonder what's in this auditorium.
Guess we'll find out.
We will? Where is it?
I should open up my focus display and see what I can find. Oh, I might be able to get up there.
Ooh, I can grapple. Nice.
Wow, that worked.
That pole caster's useful. Too bad there's only one.
Yeah, bye.
Don't worry. I'll find you another way up.
Almost didn't make it there. Gotta be careful.
Okay, I gotta drop the ladder for Varl.
Here we go, Varl. Use the ladder.
There you go, Varl.
Thanks.
Now, how do I get up there? Nothing to grapple? I guess not.
Humans, Homo sapiens, us. We have always pushed the boundary as explorers, pioneers, trailblazers. And now Far Zenith is taking the next leap into the future. That's why we're proud to have resurrected the Odyssey. When our government's abandoned in orbit, Far Zenith will actualize in less than a decade. But that's only the beginning. When the ship is complete, we will send the Odyssey and her crew where no one's gone before. The Sirius system. There, we'll create humanity's first off-world colony. The Odyssey may take 300 years to reach it. But when we look up at the night sky, we'll know they're on their way. And in the words of our founder, the late Peter Chimvumbe, the truest form of immortality is...
Data corrupt. Playback stopped.
The old ones could fly through the sky? Between the stars?
Well, yes, sort of. That ship... The Odyssey, it never made it to the other star. Something went wrong, and it blew up. Is that why Elizabeth gave them a backup of Gaia? For a colony?
Error. Public presentation file corrupted. Member recruitment file available. Do you wish to reactivate?
Yeah, reactivate. Let's see what else they had to say.
We all know the projections. Economic instability, new biocontagions, rampant AIs. How long before another catastrophe creates unacceptable risk for the world's elite? We here at Far Zenith believe, escape the inevitable. And so we reach for the stars. Now you've seen what we're building here. Infrastructure to support the Odyssey's construction. A state-of-the-art data center to facilitate rapid technological advancements. And you've seen how we're managing public perception. So invest. And join us. Claim your birth on the Odyssey. Preserve your way of life beyond the concerns of Earth.
Well, they were right about the world ending. They just didn't know how. Yet.
So everything they said back there about the next step for humanity, it was all a lie. These people only cared about saving their own skin.
Yeah, well... Didn't work out for them in the end. That Oswald guy mentioned a data center. There. The backup. It should be stored in there.
Won't be able to swim across.
I guess we'll have to find a way around. Come on.
The wilds have really grown over this place.
All right, hook it. Pull it. Atta girl.
Deeper into the creepy ruin we go.
What is that?
Might have been the chemicals I was around. Keep your guard up.
Oh, my guard is up.
Up here. Don't want those things to call in some friends from underground. You take the left one, I'll deal with the one on the right.
Okay. Moving up.
I need to sneak up on it to take it out with my spear. Can't let it see me. I should scan it first. Check its patrol path. Okay, there's its patrol path. Closer and stay out of sight.
Getting closer. Almost there. And I gotcha. Good job, Varl.
Mine's down too.
I'm proud of you.
More of those machines ahead.
Nothing you and I can't handle.
Oh, it got me. Be careful. He's about to kill him already. Heal.
Mention, I noticed you have a new look these days.
Yeah, I know. Didn't have a lot of time to shave when I was trying to catch up to you. Don't worry, it's not permanent.
Good.
Sorry my whiskers offend you, anointed.
Yeah, whiskers? I didn't notice. Where are they? I mean, you have a full-on beard. That's cool. Don't shave that. I wish I can grow a full beard. The most I can do is, I don't know what you call it, but it just grows around my mouth. You know, my chin and then my upper lip. And that's pretty much it. As far as I know, I'm still pretty young. Maybe if I leave it alone for a little bit, more will grow around my face. Because my father, he could actually grow... Man, I don't know if he can actually grow a full beard, but all I know is that he can't grow on more spots on his face than me. So I'm just hoping those dumb genetics, you know, they passed on. Because I would love to see myself with, like, a full set of beard. It wouldn't be a long one, but it, you know, wrap around my face. Should I get a fake beard? Because I know that people in, they get, like, hair plugs, right? Does that work for beards? That's such a dumb question. I'm sorry. Oh, look at these deadly pants.
It's made its way in here, too.
God, I'm just so excited to play this. It feels identical to the first game, and that is not a complaint. The first game is amazing.
The Osram must have used explosives against the machines.
They managed to get a couple.
Looks like there was a barricade here. Machines must have broken through. I'll keep this for later.
Ooh, I got a health potion.
The Osram didn't have a chance to use it.
Nice.
Careful. Traps ahead.
Huh. Might be able to disarm them. There.
There's just balloons.
And not blow yourself up.
And got more supplies. Looks like another camp.
While we're here, maybe we can make some traps of our own. Might come in handy against machines.
Good idea.
Oh, another one. Die. There has to be like a secret or some trophy where you take them all down.
Okay. I should have what I need to craft a trap.
What kind of trap do you have in mind? To craft a blast trap, hold down to open your hunter's kit and navigate to the blast trap. Craft.
There. Explosive trap made.
If anything walks into one of those, it won't know what hit it. Over here, Aloy. I think I see a way up.
Oh no, I see it. Don't worry.
Machine's head.
Don't think they spotted us. I've seen this machine before. A scrounger.
It's new to me. Let's see where its weak points are.
Maybe we could place one of those traps you made in its path.
Sure. Let's see. Tap to select the blast trap. Tap to place the trap on the ground. Okay, let's do it right here. Now I wonder, is it going to be like a one-shot hit, or is it going to take more than one? Maybe when it's unsuspected, it should take one blast. Yeah, I'm not going to strike it. It's not going to kill it, so what's the point? Let's just see what the trap does. Did it die? Oh, it died. It almost saw me. Just go right to your path. Here, let's make another one. Craft. Be careful. He's coming over here. He's gonna fall for it, don't worry about it. Just gonna have to wait.
Right into the trap.
Got it.
We're clear.
Let's keep going then.
So I'm supposed to go up there, but how? Through this way? I see a slope. Search. Grab all.
You've been in a lot of old world ruins. Are they all like this?
Whoa. That machine we saw earlier must be on the move.
Let's hope it doesn't come this way.
Big storm picking up out there.
Yeah. And they're getting stronger. And more frequent.
So the storms, the blighted lands, the rivers and lakes choked with algae. You were born to fix all that?
Yeah. This data mentions the tech that Far Zenith traded with Zero Dawn. It doesn't explain how they got it back up.
I'll keep an eye out for more data.
Thank
Looks
you.
Like we've got to climb up.
Climbing's my thing. Aloy can climb.
You okay?
Yeah. Guess we won't be going that way.
Shortcut. Oh, okay, I see. Go up this way instead. The yellow paint around for climbing is
falling apart.
Well, it is 1,000 years old.
The yellow paint is very faint, but it's still there. So I guess it's more realistic route than like very bright yellow everywhere.
Looks like some kind of meeting room. Onzu.
The Zero Dawn terraforming system, the brainchild of Dr. Elizabeth Sobeck. Empowered by 9 subordinate functions, Gaia, the core of the system, is capable of advanced planetary engineering, an obvious advantage to our space colonization efforts. Operation Phase 1. Establish an asset within Project Zero Dawn. Status complete. Phase 2. The asset will secretly beamcast a complete copy of Gaia and her subordinate functions to this facility's data center. If all goes well, Zero Dawn staff will remain completely unaware of the transmission. Risks. Discovery of this operation could result in Zero Dawn withholding the already negotiated Apollo database. Special care must be taken not to alert Travis Tate, the expert hacker in charge of Hades Protocol. In addition, extreme caution must be exercised in regards to Dr. Sobeck herself. As one of the world's preeminent technologists, she may have instituted unforeseen security measures. A complete assessment is attached. This concludes the executive summary.
I thought Elizabeth sent the backup here. But she didn't. Far Zenith stole Gaia.
Aloy? Why does that woman look like you?
It's okay, Prawl. We look alike because we're the exact same. Genetically identical.
But she was one of the old ones. How can you be her?
Because I wasn't born. I was made. By a machine. It's why I'm motherless, why I was cast out as an infant.
I don't understand. What kind of machine can make a person?
Remember when I said the backup is like a set of instructions? It's more than that. It's called Gaia. And for a long time, she cared for the world until she had to destroy herself. So she made me to bring her back. I'm the only one who can. And this place is my last hope.
You once said the goddess spoke to you when you went into All Mother Mountain. Was that this Gaia?
Yes, but she's not the goddess, Boral. There isn't one.
How can you be sure? It sounds like she anointed you with a sacred task.
I've had a lot of time to figure this out. And you will too, with the focus. But for now, the report said they were going to store the stolen copy of Gaia in the data center. So that's where we have to go. Okay?
Yeah, I could imagine the process of cloning a person would be difficult to understand for Varl. A lot of stuff, actually, technology-wise.
Huh. Look at that. Aloy, over here. I found something you could use.
What is that?
A weapon. Thanks, Varl. We should keep moving.
After you.
A weapon? Obtain Frost Blast Sling. Oh, it's a sling. This weapon fires frost bombs. Use them to against enemies to build up the brittle state. While in the brittle state, enemies are more vulnerable to impact damage. Right, because Aloy always learns.
Down here. I think we're almost back outside.
Good. Look, that must be the machine.
It's heading in the same direction we're going. Great.
Is that going to be some sort of tutorial beginner boss fight?
I could try and find a new weapon on it.
Jesus.
Looks like we can cross over here.
Backup is the last hope.
Yeah. All those places I've been these last few months, there were supposed to be more backups. But 1,000 years ago, a guy named Pharaoh purged them all.
Would he be part of Far Zenith too?
No. He was worse.
Wow.
imagine going up
machines
to
tore right through them.
New data point. Book. A journal filled with hastily scrawled glyphs. It's someone's journal. Get more blueberries. What's this? Ancient supply box.
Machine. He's patrolling ahead.
We can tag them in the focus to keep track of them.
With the focus activated, tag enemies with R2 to track their location. Right. Silent, but deadly. Okay, it's gonna turn right around, so once it gets past me, I'll go around this tree and get behind it. Silent, but deadly. It doesn't have a path, so I can't really track where it's gonna go. Can I throw a rock or something? There we go. Go towards that way. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to kill it with the strike, but I can hurt it very badly.
Machine ripped right through the wall.
How to get out of here?
It did die. Okay, I was going under the assumption that in the first game, because in the first game, you had to unlock a skill in order to do a good amount of damage to those guys, but I guess by default, you already can do that. So that's cool.
There's a ladder in the back.
I wonder, was that machine guarding anything over here? Like a supply box? Something secretive?
What's
oh, there's this thing. Ancient valuable box. Got some more ingots. Can I make a sword out of that? Medicinal berry, inventory 1 or 11. Damn, I already have a bunch of resources. I'll have arrows for days. What do you guys think? Looks good, right? The game? God, I swear, I wish I had a monitor that can capture the 4K capabilities, and I had like a device that can record all that too.
Sona was really okay with you not going back to the Sacred Lands?
As the Nora War Chief, she understood why I was obligated to follow you. But as my mother, she wasn't pleased.
Is she ever pleased? I don't think I've seen her smile.
Me neither.
Thank you.
they slaughtered all those Oseram, we'll never get through to the data center.
There's no way to slip past them. They're too tough to fight head on.
We could find a settlement. Convince some hunters to help us.
That would take weeks, and we don't have that kind of time. Maybe all we need is that shuttle to fall.
That thing? How?
We'll figure it out. Just wait here.
Aloy!
Trust me.
And there she goes.
Just need to get over to the shuttle. That tower. We should be able to find a way across to the shuttle.
Cell is but deadly. Is it coming towards me? Okay, I think I'm fine. Let's go around this way and sell it to tech.
Maybe I should stick to my spear for now.
Oh, it's on me. There, Nick. Took a plate off. Now you're life. I did not see the third one. You know, I wonder how big the map is in this game compared to the first one. You know, if it was up to me, I prefer smallish maps, but like a lot of stuff you can do, you know?
There. That ladder can get me up to the tower.
In GTA 5, the map is insanely huge. But there's rarely stuff you can do unless you're playing the online mode where they put activities covering the map. But in single player, there's really nothing you can do much, honestly. Which is very unfortunate why they never did any single player DLC.
Myself off that grapple point.
Okay, where to next? Tap to drop from a climb point.
I didn't get up high enough. I better try this again.
Wait, hold on. It's trying to teach me something. What is that? Is there a way to go up higher? Jump and tap X to attach grapple points. Tap circle before reaching a grapple point to launch into the air. Oh.
Got it.
Oh, that's cool. That's kind of like the Arkham games in Batman where you shoot a grapple, you hit a corner of a building, and it shoots right off into gliding.
Sounds good.
Hold on, there's stuff over there. Don't want to miss out on anything. Very nerve-wracking, the climbing.
On to the next. I won't be able to make that jump. There is a cable here. Maybe I can ride it to the other side.
Aloy?
Well, nowhere to go but up.
Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. We're fine. We're fine.
Looks like there are massive clamps holding the shuttle in place. I'll bet there's a control console nearby. If I can release the clamps, the shuttle should fall right into the basin. Great. More machines in my way.
They are? One, two. Is that it? Just two? Three. Okay, that it will be difficult. Let's just take them out. The best we can. And the quietest, too. Let's just go around this way. That was a close one. You can tag specific parts. That's really cool. I like that. Stealth killed 10 machines. Got a trophy. Hell yeah. I did it.
Control console might be in there. Okay. Time to crush those machines down below. I'm gonna have to climb the tower to find a way to disconnect them. Now, how to get up the tower?
A lot of climbing.
I'm
Pull that beam down. It might drop the access lift.
All right, get up there and get up here.
Gotta climb closer to the shuttle to detach the cables.
Shoot the shuttle cable connectors. Oh, I see now. I did not make it. There we go. Man, it's so cluttered here, full of vines and stuff. It's kind of hard to navigate.
Okay, the creaking doesn't sound good. I'm gonna have to detach those cables quick.
Is that it?
Shoot. One down. I just need to climb higher and attach the second set of cables. Scaling an ancient rickety tower with killer machines waiting down below. Maybe I was right. I'm turning back now.
You know, it's funny that those machines don't see that that thing above them is gonna fall and they're not doing anything about it. Like, they're literally just gonna sit there and just wait for it to fall on top of them. It's a funny thought. Did I just go backwards? Oh no, I didn't. Okay, look, it all looks the same. I thought it was backwards.
Almost there. There's the other connector.
Let's do it!
I need to take this thing down to get to the data center. I should scan for weak spots. Okay, where's that weak spot?
Weak spot, weak spot. Which one's that one?
That's the target first.
Explosive. I don't have anything explosive. Weak spot. Got it. Hey, chill out.
for that acid. Whoa! I still got some fight left in you.
Oh, I missed a critical strike. Oh, it can move. It can move. It can freely move. Okay, what was that all about?
I broke free. I've got to take this thing down fast. Track me, frost ammo. Where my focus might find something I can use around here.
This thing, what is it?
Let's see what this can do.
Die, bitch! Level 2!
Finally!
Spend skill points. Whoa, what is all this? Warrior, Trapper, Hunter, Survivor, Infiltrator, Machine Master. Where should we start with?
The data center should be straight ahead. I guess Farrell's gonna have to find another way there.
Let's do it!
Once I get the backup, I can reboot Gaia. Fix the system, heal the Blight. Restore Elizabeth's dream. But is it still there?
I mean, we can only hope.
I'm close. I have to be.
Oh, I got a ring. That could be worth a lot. Text log, data corruption, partial.
Please be here. It's here.
Gaia version 6.9. Initializing. Hello.
Hi. Elizabeth? Travis Tate.
Now, what's this we got here? A Farzan's conspiracy to steal a copy of Gaia? And her subordinate functions? Naughty, naughty. You want me to handle this, Liz? Blasphemers! Brood of vipers! With a mighty hand I smite and pour troubles upon you!
Thank you.
This ain't no copy of Guy you stole, you losers. But it's the mother of all logic bombs. So good luck repairing your data. And next time you start thinking you can outsmart a Tate, remember my salute.
Aloy?
The goddess.
There is no goddess. I told you that already. That's not Gaia. It's not what I'm looking for. It's nothing but a fake.
Sharp bite sometimes, you know. But it was pretty amazing to see you fly off that tower and blow up the entire basin.
The thing is, there's going to be more of that. I'm out of leads, Varl. But I have to keep searching. And fast, and whatever risks I have to take, I will. And it doesn't make sense to have someone with me. Someone who might get hurt. This is on me, Varl. Nobody else.
Hold on. Before, in Meridian, you said there was a man who helped you. Silence. You said you used to talk to him a lot about things you discovered from the old world, things no one else understands. And he gave you the lance you used to defeat Hades.
He's gone, Varl. I haven't heard from him since the battle against Hades.
Sure, but Spymaster Murad back in Meridian, he's good at finding people, isn't he?
Varl, I...
Come on, it might work. Plus, you'll get to see some friendly faces again.
Okay. I guess it's worth a shot.
We've got a long walk ahead.
Actually, I've got a better idea.
Savior of Meridian has returned.
You earned this welcome. You saved them.
Not yet.
In the name of the Sun King of Vard, a royal welcome for the champion.
Make way. Murad, Aloy has an urgent matter to discuss.
Dashain, that makes two of us. I've sent forth hunters for weeks. The Sunfall all the way to the Sacred Land, searching for you. Something happened at the Spire. Come. I'll show you.
Watch your step. You saved us all, to be sure, but we're still cleaning up the mess.
It happened right after the solstice. We were able to explain it away, thank the sun. Otherwise, it might have caused a panic.
One night,
For less than half a minute, it glowed an angry red. From Meridian, it looked like a trick of the light. But those who were closer, atop the alight, said it could not have been a reflection. Much to my dismay, they said the light rose up from the tower's base. From that. We left everything just as it was.
What do you think happened?
I don't know. The Spire's supposed to send out signals, messages, for the terraforming system.
But Hades tried to use it to wake up ancient war machines.
I was sure I cut the connection to that thing. Wait here while I check it out.
Let us know what you find.
Alright, so our objective is to examine the orb that contained Hades. And I will do that in the next one. I think I played enough for now. Right, so this is a really fun game. I like the intro so far. It's really good. And yeah, can't wait to play more of it. See you in the next one when I post more of Horizon Forbidden West. See ya.